Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. My name is Ron Morton. I'm the deacon in charge, if you don't know me. I'm going to do the sermon later so you get to know me better, whether you like it or not. It's been a crazy week. There's no doubt about that we're here today to join again in our relationship with Jesus Christ. But we'll do that today. I don't really have a whole lot of announcements. My expectation is that now that I'm coming back from having the surgery on the foot, that I'll be sitting down with Nancy at some point soon here and we're talking about these things. Amber, Lord, I've missed you. We really have.
Ron,
he only missed one Sunday.
The service of St. James for Helen the Haven is this coming Saturday.
This Saturday?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
The service for Helen,
previous vestry member, is this Saturday at St. James.
St. James.
I think it's 4 o'clock.
Is it 4 o'clock?
Yeah.
I will be there. The loss of Helen was a shock. Uh-huh. It was unexpected. It was like one day she was here and next week she wasn't. Good person, hard driving. She didn't mind doing the things that needed to get done, so if you can break loose to honor her on Saturday, it would be a wonderful thing. It really would. Thank you for that reminder. Any other reminders? I'm not going to process it today because of my cane and my foot. I'll stay up here. Everything else will be relatively the same in the way that we've been doing it here during this period of time after Easter. You have your prayer book that we put together for you that actually Gail worked really hard on with other folks to put together so that we could be consistent through this period of time. Gail will be back. She'll need to be back by the second week in August because that's when she preaches.
August.
She could be gone. She and Jim will be gone on vacation to Wyoming, and Jim is actually going up too.
A conference too. Yeah.
And I've done that drive by myself to that area. Well, I did it about 50 times that I could think of over the years. You got to be careful if you're driving up there. You got to be careful. Those long distance, nothing but rows of corn. If you have to stop out in one of them fields of corn, it's going to cost you a mint to get towed anyway. I know. Bunch of poor Indians going to Sundance, cars are going to break down. We're going up there, we have cars breaking down all the time. So we just stop, do maintenance, and get on with it. A bunch of Indian folks that have skills, yeah.
Have you already announced that the hymns are on the hymn board?
No, but thank you.
Yeah.
The hymns are on the hymn board.
Thank you.
You can see them.
And then SuZanne or somebody will announce them as we go. So your first hymn is 11:165. And then stay at 11 for a couple of minutes. So Gloria and the sequence. 165 is up first. 11.
Okay. For those of you who don't know, I'm back in full form, I hope. I saw my doctor Friday. He says I'm healing very well and very quickly now. Imagine that, staying off the bath foot with healing. Who would know that? He's a good doctor. He's very honest with me. That's what I need. But he says in 3 weeks I have to be out of this boot. And as soon as I'm out of this boot, I'm out fishing. fishing. It's time for fishing. Let's do this.
Thank you. First reading from Jeremiah. prophet Jeremiah spoke to the prophet Hananiah in the presence of the priest and all the people who were standing in the house of the Lord. And the prophet Jeremiah said, Amen. May the Lord do so. May the Lord fulfill the words that you have prophesied. And bring back to this place from Babylon the vessels of the house of the Lord and all of the exile. But listen now to this word that I speak to you, to your hearing, and in the hearing of all people. The prophets who preceded you and me for ancient times prophesied war, famine, and pestilence against many countries and great kingdoms. As for the prophet who prophesies peace, when the word of that prophet comes true, then it will be known that the Lord has truly sent the prophet. Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us read responsibly, governed by the Esther's Psalm 89. Your love, O Lord, forever will I sing.
From age to age, my mouth will proclaim your faithfulness.
For I am persuaded that your love is established forever.
You have set your faithfulness firmly in the heavens.
I have made a covenant with my chosen one.
I have sworn an oath to David, my servant.
I will establish your line forever
and preserve your throne for all generations.
Happy are the people who know the festival shall.
They walk, O Lord, in the light of your presence.
They rejoice daily in your name.
They are jubilant in your righteousness.
For you are the glory of their strength,
and by your favor our might is exalted.
Truly, the Lord is our ruler.
The Holy One of Israel is our King.
A second reading from Romans. Do not let sin exercise dominion in your mortal bodies to make you obey their passions. No longer present your members to sin as instruments of wickedness, but present yourselves to God as those who have been brought from death to life. And present your members to God as instruments of righteousness. For sin will have no dominion over you, since you are not under law, but under grace. What then? Should we sin because we are not under law, but under grace? By no means. Do you not know that if you present yourselves to anyone as obedient slaves, you are slaves of the one whom you obey, either of sin, which leads to death, or of obedience, which leads to righteousness? But thanks be to God that you, having once been slaves of sin, have become obedient from the heart to the form of teaching to which you were entrusted. And that you, having been set free from sin, have become slaves of righteousness. I am speaking in human terms because of the natural limitations. For just as you once presented your members as slaves to impurity and to greater and greater iniquity, so now present your members as slaves to righteousness, for sanctification. When you were slaves of sin, you were free in regard to righteousness. So what advantage did you then get from the things of which you now are ashamed? The end of those things is death. But now that you have been freed from sin and enslaved to God, the advantage you get is sanctification. The end is eternal life. For the wages of sin is death. But the free gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Whoever welcomes a prophet in the name of the prophet
will receive a prophet's reward, and whoever welcomes a righteous person in the name of a righteous person will receive the reward of the righteous. And whoever gives even a cup of cold water to one of these little ones in the name of a disciple, truly I tell you, none of these will lose their reward. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
You know how many people don't see you in a cart at Food City? It is ridiculous. You're in this big thing, you know. You're going down the aisle. They're coming at you. And they don't move. So it's funny, all these things that go through my mind on a morning when I'm dealing with my foot. There's several things I got to do. I got to bandage it, which is not a big deal. I've become very proficient in bandaging my foot, almost to the point of loving my foot.
Oh, that's good. Yeah.
You know what? It's one of those members that Paul is talking about. This foot gets me where I need to go. And I'm proud for how this foot has stood up in spite of my own silliness. But I have a lot of time to think when I'm trying to decide how I'm going to get this crazy half steel boot on. And the other foot, you know, I got another foot. It's not getting much attention. That only has to do peripherally with what I'm talking about today. Are you enslaved to God? Ooh, that's a tough thing, isn't it? A lot of things have happened this week. Some things have made me angry. Maybe so angry that I could cry. I'm a person who benefited from being an Indian in my education. I did. It wasn't affirmative action. The tribes were set up by Indian health services to deal with some issues around education. One of the things that they would do is they would give you money for education as long as you did a payback in the community. Well, I did that for a long time. But I still ended up with student loans. A lot of people did. It was the only way we could get through college. I couldn't go to college without loans. I mean, the tuition at the college I was going to was ridiculous. It's ridiculous at most decent universities. But I did it, and I got to pay that money back, no matter what. That's the deal I made. That wasn't affirmative action. That came from the federal government through a different avenue to make sure that Indians could get educated so they could take care of their own people. And a lot of Indians are taking advantage of that. They're going to college, government's paying for it, and then they go back to the reservation and work as nurses or doctors, in my case, psychologists. I worked in the San Diego American Indian Health Center for quite a while as a person running mental health programs. The interesting thing was that none of those counted to help pay back my student loans. So I did all that work. I actually was going to school full time, and I was running the San Diego American Indian Health Center full time. I don't know how I did it. Well, I was younger. But that was the way that it was when I was trying to get my education, when I was trying to get those degrees that are so important, that made me a specialist on you. I'm an expert on you, because I'm a psychologist, so I know how y'all think. Yeah, try that one with my wife. I love my wife. I joke about her a lot. I love her dearly. And she's a commander. And sometimes she has to get my attention, and I appreciate that, because I'm slow to attend to things sometimes. But am I enslaved to God? Am I righteous? Am I righteous, understanding that part of that reward is a relationship with Jesus Christ? You can't serve two masters. You ever been at work when somebody was your manager but somebody else wanted to give you orders? That kind of happened to me once in the Navy, once or twice in the Navy. We straightened that out. But it was difficult, confusing, and maybe dangerous on the ship. Who do I serve? Do I serve the Lord Jesus Christ with all my heart and all my mind? Because if I'm serving another master, and we're talking about these kinds of things, who would be the other master? When I do something, I'm ashamed of it. I pray to God for forgiveness. Every Sunday we do that. But who is that relationship with where I feel guilty and ashamed? Part of being a Christian is being able to give that over, understanding that the Lord knows that we're humans. But if you ask for forgiveness and continue to do the same things over and over again, that means a couple of things. It may mean you're not really all that together. But what it also means is that if you're not serving Jesus, I think, that you're adding to the illness in the world. For us, Jesus Christ has to be the point. We serve Jesus Christ. Raise your hand if you serve Jesus Christ. The best way that you can, right? Don't lose heart. Jesus said, we'll receive our reward. If we recognize, develop, and nurture that relationship with the Lord, I believe he's just waiting for us to say hello. Do you say hello to God? I mean, how do you pray? If you get up in the morning, do you say, hi, God, I'm here? Or do you go into something heavier and more extensive? You know, I like the idea of saying hi to God in the morning. I like the idea of saying hi to Jesus Christ in the morning, because it reinforces that I have that relationship, that I'll never lose that relationship. But that means I have to look at who I'm serving. There's a dark world out there. There's some dark aspects to it, and they're showing their face. The dark things are showing their face in ways that have surprised us, infuriated us, maybe wanted us to go out and march. It's an interesting word. My marching days may be over. But this is where you go to who you are inside, the core of yourself as a human being and as a servant of Christ. You go there and you pray, whatever form it takes. And then you go out into the world out there and you do your best to act like Jesus Christ. Will we ever be like Jesus Christ? In some ways, yes, that's a promise. To be like Jesus Christ means that most of the time you don't have to worry about whether or not you're righteous. You just do the right thing. And we're living in a world where it's not getting done all that much, the right thing. What do we have to tick off this last week? Abortion, affirmative action, gay rights. There are people out there who want to get rid of all these things, all the work that's been done to help people who are less fortunate. It's a threatening thing. So where do we go? We go to the Lord. You could either be angry all the time, or you could be like Jesus. Jesus Christ. Can't say that name enough today. Righteousness. Am I righteous? You be the judge. I'm hard on myself in terms of whether or not I'm righteous. But I look at all these faces and I see the message. Good to be back with y'all. Paige, good to see you, Paige. Embry, I missed you. I really do. You know, all of you folks, Trish in the back there, Rick, you know, all of you. Those days that I was out sitting at home watching as many episodes of First Alaskan as I can get under my belt. I mean, what do you do when you're laying flat on your back? That's what I was doing, First Alaskan, seeing every episode. What else have I seen every episode? That happens when you're laying flat on your back. But anyway, I am so really, truly happy to be back here with all of you. SuZanne, thanks for the help. Gail Brown. What can I say? Gail's my friend. She is a servant of Christ, as are all you. God bless you all. Have a great day today. It's a good life, isn't it? Amen.
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 Now, would y'all please stand and express your faith with me according to the Nicene Creed, which is in your prayer.
We believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified by the Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, she is worshipped and glorified. She has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Gracious God, you have promised to hear what we ask in the name of your Son.
In confidence and trust,
we pray for the church.
God of power and might, enliven the church for her mission.
That we may be salt of the earth and light to the world.
Breathe fresh life into your people.
Give us power to reveal Christ in word and action.
We pray for the world. God, creator of all, lead us and every people into the ways of justice and peace.
That we may respect one another in freedom and truth.
Awaken us a sense of wonder for the earth and all that is in it.
Teach us to care creatively for its resources.
We pray for community. God of truth, inspire with your wisdom those whose decisions affect the lives of others.
All may act with integrity and courage.
Give grace to all whose lives are linked with ours.
May we serve Christ in one another and love as he loves us.
We pray for those in need, God of hope, comfort, and restore all who suffer in body, mind, or spirit.
May they know the healing power of your love.
Make us willing agents of your compassion.
Strengthen us as we share in making people whole.
I was told that now we were going to have a special prayer. prayer. That's good, Case?
Yeah.
Okay.
Dear Lord, we have someone here today who's grieving for a person who has gone on to the other side. Chris is asking for special blessings for his son, Chris. We're humbled by the fact that she asked us to pray. And we praise you, Lord, that she knows she can come here and ask for those prayers. Lord, descend on Trish. Be with Chris on the other side. We ask for peace for all of those who have lost a loved one. We ask this in the name of your son.
Amen. Amen.
Okay.
Give comfort to those who mourn.
Bring peace in their time of loss.
We praise you for all your saints, God of light and joy. Teach and encourage us also.
May we too trust in your love, serve your purpose, and praise your name through Christ Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
God has promised forgiveness to all who truly repent. Let us turn to Christ in faith and receive God's forgiveness. Most merciful God,
we have sinned in what we have thought and said, in the wrong we have done, and in the good we have not done. We have sinned in ignorance, we have sinned in weakness, we have sinned through our
own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry. We repent and turn to you. Forgive us for our Savior Christ's sake. And renew our lives to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also
Thank you.
Our service continues on page 6 in the worship booklet. All things come of thee, O Lord.
And I alone have given thee.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give you our thanks and praise.
You have included us in creation and made us in your glorious image. You have remembered us from our beginning and fed us with your constant love. You have redeemed us in Jesus Christ and knit us into one body. Through your Spirit, you replenish us and call us the fullness of life. Therefore, joining with angels and archangels and with all the faithful in every generation, we give voice to all creation as we sing. Everlasting heritage of your
with all your saints, past and yet to come, we may praise your name forever.
With Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, O God, now and forever. Amen.
As our Savior Christ has taught us, we now pray.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread.
Forgive us our sins,
as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Thank you.
your kingdom. And now, Holy God,
send us out to do the work you have given us to do, to love and serve you as faithful witnesses of Christ our Lord.
To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit, be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen.
Live without fear. The Creator has made you holy and has always protected you and loves you as a mother. Go in peace to follow the good road, and may God's blessing, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with you all.
Amen.
Hymn number 718 in the prayer book. Oh, no.
Hot
so
June.
Possibly.